There are several types of two-stroke gasoline engines. Do you know them all? What happens if the crankcase compression is increased? Different shapes of pistons? Why do the exhausts have this shape? Is it possible to start an engine backwards? How does it improve with direct injection? Let's start. The most basic two-stroke engine has a small number of parts. Instead of having valves, they have ports. These ports are simple holes through which air passes, and they open depending on whether the piston blocks them or not. Unlike a normal four-stroke, the two-stroke performs several tasks at the same time, burning fuel in each revolution of the crankshaft, while the four-stroke does it every two revolutions. This means that the two-stroke has double the theoretical performance. Let's look at this process in detail. First, when the piston goes up, it uncovers the intake port, and at the same time creates a vacuum, forcing the mixture to enter the crankcase. Then the piston goes down, compressing the crankcase. At the same time, it stops blocking the transfer passages. The mixture now flows rapidly into the cylinder. When the piston begins to go up, it blocks the port and begins the compression stroke. The spark fires and the piston descends, uncovering the exhaust port. At that moment, the gases leave the cylinder, while at the same time, the gases that had been compressed in the crankcase enter. As seen, the intake and exhaust of the cylinder occur at the same time. The main problem with this is that a certain amount of mixture goes through the exhaust port without being burned, since all the ports are open. The second problem is that the crankcase must be pressurized to allow intake and then compression into the cylinder. This disables oil from being stored in this location. Oil is usually mixed with gasoline, and in the most sophisticated ones, a pump is used to inject oil into the crankcase. In any case, this oil ends up burning, causing notorious white smoke. This engine that we see is the most simple of all. The piston performs the port opening, and when we try to improve performance, we have to modify the ports. This allows you to advance and increase the time that the ports remain open, and thus increase the flow of gases. It's the equivalent of modifying the camshaft in a four-stroke engine. However, this basic two-stroke engine has a reduced margin since it depends on the piston. Widening the ports improves power, but reduces the life of the rings. These tend to get hooked and bite the ports since pressure is lost in this area and they come out. This practice is only reserved for racing engines and short lifespans. One solution is to leave columns to keep the ring inside. Two-stroke engine with reed valves. The operation is the same as before, but now the intake to the crankcase is not limited by the piston. A special metal sheet is used that opens when the piston goes up due to the underpressure that it creates. And when the piston goes down, beginning the crankcase compression stage, the reed pedal turns back and closes. This significantly increases the time it remains open, and does so regardless of the position of the piston, achieving much more power. It basically performs the role of a one-way valve. This system is more expensive than the first one, and pedals must be flexible and provide a perfect seal, since a leak would end up decreasing intake and losing power. Although the reed valve gives excellent results, there's a slight downtime where the vacuum is generated and then the reed opens. The same thing happens when it closes, giving a few moments of delay. We now move on to the two-stroke with rotary valve. The crankshaft has this wheel that can be adjusted as desired and that opens the intake slightly before the piston begins to rise, maximizing the opening time. The same thing happens when it closes. There are practically no dead moments and there is great precision with the control of gas entry. Nevertheless, this entire mechanism increases the weight and complexity of the engine, as well as the cost, which is why it's not widely used. Rotary valves can be used at any port. Piston shape. The most used in the past was with a deflector. This hump had the main role of bending the incoming gases to better clean the cylinder and sweep away all the already burned gases, while preventing the clean gases from going directly through the exhaust pipe. This deflector was no longer used because it added weight to the piston. As you know, the weight of moving parts is the main enemy of high RPM, and two-stroke engines need to spin very fast. A conventional engine easily spins at 12,000 RPM, while a racing engine exceeds 20,000. Another problem with the bulged piston is that it absorbs more heat in this area and increases knocking. The second type of piston is the flat crown. Cylinder scavenging is achieved by improving the angle of the ports rather than adding a wall to the piston. This design allows it to rotate at a higher number of revolutions since the piston is lighter. The third type of piston is the one that has a window. Some engines do not have space to place the intake elsewhere, so the port is placed in the cylinder as in the engine at the beginning of the video. At the same time, we want to use a reed valve, so we use a piston with a window, and it no longer has the effect of opening or closing the port, leaving the task to the reeds. In some cases, you can replace the piston with one that has no window, with the only drawback that the pumping losses will slightly increase. Another thing you may notice is that it only has two rings instead of three. That's because the third oil scraper ring is not necessary. An extra difference that exists with a two-stroke engine is that bearings are used in the crankshaft, in the connecting rod, and in the pin, since the lubrication system is more precarious. Conrods are usually in one piece instead of two, as in a four-stroke engine. The appearance of direct injection was good news for the two-stroke engine. Instead of a carburetor, where fuel is supplied from the beginning, passes through the entire engine, and then runs the risk of leaving the cylinder without being burned, direct injection delivers the fuel right into the combustion chamber, so you can wait until the intake and exhaust ports are closed and then inject it. This eliminates fuel loss. However, the loss and burning of oil still remains, the main reason why environmental regulations do not allow its use in road cars. Is it possible to start a two-stroke engine backwards? Yes, if the engine runs a lot of advanced ignition timing, it is normal that when kicking it to start, the engine bounces and starts in reverse. As there are no camshafts that do have a mandatory direction of rotation, the engine can run indefinitely in the opposite direction. There is a problem since the driver has no way of knowing, so when accelerating, waiting for the vehicle to go forward, it goes backwards, causing the driver to fall. When running backwards, if the ignition timing is not corrected, the engine also has less performance. Conical exhaust. The gases leave the cylinder and expand along the cone. This pressure causes a rebound wave that is directed towards the cylinder and must arrive at the right time to prevent the fresh mixture that expelled the exhaust gases from also escaping. To do this, the exhaust must be correctly sized in shape and length for the revolutions at which we'll operate the engine. Otherwise, the counterpressure wave would arrive too early or late and the effect would be lost. The factory exhausts already perform this function using internal walls, but normally for a lower RPM number, which is where the normal user usually uses it. The racing ones are tuned to a higher RPM number. This means that the engine will have less power at low RPM and then recover at high RPM. It's very important that two-stroke engines have an exhaust, since without this back pressure effect, almost all of the gases would escape from the cylinder and performance will drop. Crankcase compression. In addition to varying the compression ratio of the cylinder, which is achieved by lowering the cylinder head, or by moving the height of the port, since compression does not begin until the port is closed, the crankcase can also be filled. Since there is more compression in this sector, when the piston discovers the port, the mixture will flow with more energy towards the cylinder, improving filling. The problem with this practice is that losses also increase. When the piston goes down, it encounters more resistance and loses power. Normally, a highly compressed crankcase gives more power at high revs, while a decompressed one gives it at low revs. The compression ratio of the crankcase is approximately 1.5 to 1. A 50cc engine will have a 150cc crankcase. When replacing internal parts, be careful with the volume. In the past, the cylinder had a compression ratio of 7 to 1, although today high values of 12 to 1 are reached. What are variable ports? Four-stroke engines use variable camshafts. In two-stroke engines, there are variable ports. This piece moves forward and delays the opening of the exhaust, improving power at low RPM by preventing the mixture from leaving the cylinder. Benefits of the two-stroke engine. It's simpler and has fewer parts. They do not have valves that are difficult to operate and have hard springs. There's less possibility of failure by not having a belt that controls them. It produces power with each turn of the crankshaft, so its theoretical performance is double compared to a four-stroke. The engine is very light, and for this reason it's mainly used in portable engines such as lawnmowers or motorcycles, whether small or racing. With no complex lubrication system, the engine can operate in any orientation, meaning you can do stunts without compromising engine life as you would with a four-stroke, which would run out of oil if the pump can't take it. Cons of the two-stroke engine. When descending a mountain, the motorcycle usually descends by gravity, with the engine revving as being used as an engine brake. The use of the accelerator is minimal. This means that no fuel or oil mixture enters the engine, causing the engine to wear and tear. Of course, this only happens in engines with no oil pump. It must burn oil to lubricate itself. It produces very high emissions and therefore cannot be manufactured for normal use like a four-stroke. The catalysts are not friendly to oil burning that blocks the tiny passages. Catalysts are also complicated with tuning the exhaust pulse. The ports produce fuel waste in the carburetor version. Carbon buildup in the spark plug can leave you stranded at any time. It's advisable to push the engine to its maximum from time to time so that the temperature keeps the engine clean. However, since 1970, specific oils for two-stroke engines appeared and are designed to burn cleanly and without residue, so this effect is diminished, although not completely. It consumes more fuel compared to a four-stroke since the combustion stroke is not used 100% and is interrupted by the opening of the exhaust port. There are two-stroke diesel engines. I leave the video here so you can see it. Check the comments section as there are always people writing more information and feel free to leave yours. I also invite you to leave your like and subscribe for more videos. See you next time, and thanks for watching.